Hi students, welcome back. In the last session we have discussed about arithmetic progressions and what is arithmetic progressions and the fundamentals of it. Today we are going to discuss about nth term of an AP. Nth term of an AP. How that formula an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d is derived. Now let us take an example 3, 7, 11, etc. Anyhow, the first term is a is equal to 3 and d will be knowing that a2 minus a1. a2 is 7 minus 3 is 4. D is 4. Now a2 is nothing but a1 plus d. a1 plus d. That is a1 is 3. 3 plus 4 is 7. 3 plus 4 is 7. A3 is equal to A2 plus D. A2. What is A2 here? A2 is 7 plus 4 is equal to 11. In another words, if you see here, we have a comparison here. A2 is equal to A plus 2 minus 1 into D. 2 minus 1 into D. That is a plus d or 1d. Then a3 is equal to a plus 3 minus 1 into d is equal to a plus d. If I wanted the nth term, then an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. This is the formula to find the general term of an AP. If you know this formula, you can find the any of this for this one. That is, if you know n, you can find. If you know an, a, and d, you can find n. Or if you can find anything from this. By using this formula, we can find any three of this. For example, we'll see if a is 7, d is equal to, then we have to find an. We have to find an. If a is equal to 7, d is equal to 3, and n is equal to 8, we have to find an. We have the formula that an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. So an we are going to find. What is a? A is 7 plus what is n? 8. 8 minus 1 into d is 3. So 7 plus 8 minus 1 is 7 into 3. So 7 plus 7, 3 is 21 is 28. So a 8, that is 8th term of this AP is 28. So in the previous sum you have seen, if a, d, n, and if they have given, we found an. In this case, we have a, n, and an. We are going to find d by using the same formula. That is, an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. So a is minus 18 plus n is 10 minus 1, and d we are going to find, but an is 0. Then if minus 18 comes this side, minus 18 comes this side, it will become plus 18. 10 minus 1 is 9 into d. Then d is equal to, these two are in multiplication. If it comes this side, it will be in division. So 9 2s are d is equal to 2. One more example we are going to see. In this, d is given and n is given, an is also given. We are going to find a by using the same formula. That is, an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. So an is given as minus 5, and a we are going to keep as it is because we are going to find a. And n is 18. From the formula, minus 1. n minus 1 and d is minus 3. So minus 5 into a plus 18 minus 1 is 17 into minus 3. So we have to do by Bodmer's rule, we have to do multiplication first. On that condition, minus into plus is minus. 3 7s are 21, 3 1s are 3 plus 2, 51. So if this 51 comes this side, minus 5 plus 51 is equal to a. So a is equal to 46 in this case. In this, a is given, d is given, an is given. So we are going to find n. So the same formula, that is an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. So a n is 3.6. a is minus 18.9 plus n, we don't know, n minus 1, and d is 2.5. d is 2.5. this minus, if you bring this side, 3.6 plus 18.9 is equal to n minus 1 into 2.5. so 6 plus 9, 15. 22.5 is equal to n minus 1 into 2.5. 2.5 into n minus 1, 2.5 n minus 2.5. Then if you bring this 2.5 this side, 22.5 plus 2.5 will be equal to 2.5 n. So 22.5 plus 2.5 is 25.0 is equal to 2.5 n. That implies n is equal to 25 by 2.5. 2.5 ones are, 2.5 tens are. Which that implies n is equal to 10. That is 10th term will be 3.6 in this AP. In the previous sums, we have seen everything was given directly. That is, A was given, D was given, N was given, AN was given, any one of them will be asked. But in this case, what are you going to do? They have not given A, D, anything clearly. But we have to find this missing term. How to find? So, we know that this one is called first term, second term, third term, fourth term. So, first term, and we are going to find A1 and A4, we are going to, A3, we are going to find. So we have A2. A2 means A plus D. A plus D they have given as 13. And this is A4. A4 is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. If you use that formula, A plus 3D is equal to 3. A plus 3D is equal to 3. How to, we can, if you solve these two equations, we will get D and you can find A, and the remaining, the missing terms we can find. So we are going to subtract. When you subtract, the plus will become minus, minus will become plus. Minus A plus A gets cancelled. Minus 3D plus 2D is minus 2D, and 13 minus 3 is 5. 13 minus 3 is 10. Then D is equal to 10 by minus 2. 2 ones are, 2 fives are. So D is equal to minus 5. D is equal to minus 5. Substitute in any one of this equation. Therefore, A plus D is equal to 13, then A plus of minus 5 is equal to 13. So A is equal to plus into minus minus a plus into minus, minus 5 is equal to 13, then a is equal to 13 plus 5 is 18. A is 18 and a 3 is equal to a plus 2d. A is 18 plus 2 into minus 5, 18 minus 10 is equal to 8. So A3 is equal to 8. The missing terms are So most of the students will go wrong when it comes to word problems. So only we are taking only word problems here. So determine the AP whose third term is 16 and seventh term exceeds fifth term by 12. Whenever you solve the problem, you should write what is given. The given thing is third term. Third term means A3. A3 can be written as A plus 2 times D is 16 they gave. Third term is given. What they asked is determine the AP. The first three or four terms they are asking. So, and one more condition is given. So the seventh term. Seventh term means A7. Seventh term means A7 is seventh term exceeds fifth term. So, seventh term is 12 more than the fifth term. Seventh term is 12 more than the fifth term. So these are the two conditions they have given. By using these two conditions, we are going to find the AP. That is the first three terms we are going to find. Now A7 means A plus 6D by using the general term of an AP. Similarly, A5 is A plus 4D plus 12. 4D plus 12. Bring all A's and D's one side. So A, if you bring this A this side, A minus A plus 6D, plus 4D if it comes this side, minus 4D is equal to 12. All the variables we brought, plus A minus A will be 0. 6D minus 4D is 2D is equal to 12. Then D is equal to 12 by 2. 2 1s are 2, 6 are. So D is equal to 6. So when D is equal to 6, it is very easy for us to find A, because we have the equation 1 as A plus 2D is equal to 16. A plus 2 into D is 6 is equal to 16. 2, 6 are 12 is equal to 16. So A is equal to 16 minus 12 is 4. So A is equal to 4. Then the AP is, the first term is 4. The next term what we should do means we should add the fixed value or the common difference D. 4 plus 6, 10. 10 plus 6, 16. 16 plus 6, 22 is the AP.
ನಾವು ಮಾಡ್ತಿರೋ ವಿಡಿಯೋಗಳು ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಇಷ್ಟ ಆಗಿದ್ದಲ್ಲಿ ಲೈಕ್ ಮಾಡಿ, ಶೇರ್ ಮಾಡಿ, ಸಬ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ ಮಾಡಿ. ಪಕ್ಕದಲ್ಲಿರೋ ಬೆಲ್ ಐಕನ್ ಅನ್ನ ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಮಾಡೋ ವಿಡಿಯೋಗಳ ನೋಟಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ನಿಮಗೆ ಮೊದಲು ಬರ್ತದೆ. ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿ ಸಂದೇಹಗಳಿದ್ರೆ ಕಮೆಂಟ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ತಿಳಿಸಿ, ಹಾಗೆ ಈ ತರಗತಿಗಳು ಹೆಚ್ಚಿನ ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳಿಗೆ ತಲುಪುವಂತೆ ಶೇರ್ ಮಾಡಿ.